In this example, I'll show you how those three tests for symmetry work. Test the following equation for symmetry with respect to A, the x-axis, B, the y-axis, and C, the origin. Here's our equation, x squared plus y minus 9 equals 0. Let's test for x-axis symmetry first. So remember, everywhere we see a y, we're going to plug in negative y. Now let's just remove grouping symbols. X squared plus a negative y is just x squared minus y, then minus 9 equals 0. What we want to do is check and see, is that the same as what was printed in our notes? Well, no, it is not. So no, it does not have x-axis symmetry. Let's check for y-axis symmetry. So that means everywhere we see an x, we're going to plug in negative x. So make sure to use grouping symbols when you have powers. We don't do anything to the y or to the minus 9, but negative x squared is equivalent to x squared, and this does look exactly the same as what's printed on our paper. And lastly, let's check for origin symmetry. So for origin symmetry, we need to both substitute negative x for x and negative y for y. And I'm sure you can kind of already tell what the answer is going to be here, because we've done both of these simplifications. Negative x squared does become x squared, but plus a negative y becomes minus y. And so this is not equivalent to the original problem, so this is a no. So all we have here is y-axis symmetry. Let's really quickly look at this. I'm just going to a graphing calculator called Desmos on the internet, and I've typed in x squared plus y minus 9 equals 0 up in the execution line, and here's the graph that we have, and that does look like it has y-axis symmetry. We could fold, if we could fold, the graph on the y-axis. This graph would map onto itself. It's a mirror image to the left of the y-axis as to the right of the y-axis.